Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create a fun, simple tessellation. Basically, a tessellation is a repeat pattern in which its positive and negative spaces fit into each other like a puzzle. The negative shapes create the positive pattern, and the positive shapes create the negative pattern. If you want, you could even add lines or textures to them. Make sure your foreground and background colors are black and white respectively. If they're not, press D on your keyboard. Create a new document by going to File and New. Make your document a square. For this example, I'll make the width and the height 870 pixels each and the resolution 150 pixels per inch. Fill it with black by pressing Alt-Delete on Windows or Option-Delete on a Mac. This fills it with the foreground color, which is black. We'll add guidelines that will divide it into 9 equal sections. To do this, go to View and make sure Rulers and Snap are checked. If they aren't, just click on them. Click New Guide and tick Horizontal. In the Position field, type in 33.33%. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. If you don't see the guideline, press Ctrl or Command H. Go back to View, New Guide, and this time type in 66.66%. Then press Enter or Return. Go back to View, New Guide, and tick Vertical. Type in 33.33%, press Enter or Return, go back to View, New Guide, and type in 66.66%. Go to the ruler on the left and drag out a guideline until it snaps to the left side of your document. Drag another one across until it snaps to the right side. Go to the top ruler and drag guidelines to the top and bottom. Open your rectangular marquee tool and drag a selection across the middle square. It'll snap to the guidelines because we have snap checked. We'll cut the square from the background and copy it to its own layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Hold down Ctrl or Command as you click on the square to make a selection of its shape again. Click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the active layer. Click the black square to make it active and hide the guidelines by pressing Ctrl or Command H. Click off the eyeball of the background to temporarily hide it and invert the foreground and background colors by pressing X on your keyboard or by clicking this curved double arrow icon. Next, we're going to draw two shapes inside of it. They can be any shapes you like, as long as they don't touch each other. One shape is at the top, and the other shape is on the right or left side. To draw them, you could use any tool you like, such as the pen tools, any of the lasso tools, or as in this example, the pencil tool. I'll keep the size small and the hardness 100%. Draw a shape at the top and on one of the sides. If you use the pencil tool, fill in the shapes with the paint bucket tool. Click inside each of the shapes to fill them in. Click the eyeball back on next to the background to make it visible. Go to Select and Color Range. Select Highlights and click OK. This makes a selection of the white shapes. Once you have their selections, open your lasso tool and make sure the icon to intersect the selections is highlighted. Draw around the top shape so it retains this selection as it deselects the other. Press Ctrl or Command J to cut and copy the top shape to its own layer. Hide the top layer and go back to Select and Color Range. Press Enter or Return and this time draw around the selection of the other shape. Click the thumbnail of the original shapes to make the layer active and press Ctrl or Command J to cut and copy the lower shape to its own layer. Make the guidelines visible again by pressing Ctrl or Command H. Press V on your keyboard to open your Move tool and drag the side shape across until it snaps to the opposite side of the middle box. Make the top layer visible and active. Now, drag the top shape straight down until it snaps below the bottom of the middle box. Click the thumbnail of the original shape's layer to make it active and invert it by pressing Ctrl or Command I. The shape that you have on your screen is the tile that will eventually comprise your tessellation. Go to Select and Color Range to make a selection of it. Make the top layer active and click the New Layer icon to make a new layer above it. Press Alt or Option plus Delete to fill the selection with white. Now that we've created the final shape, we can trash the layers below it that comprised it. Make the shape active and make three copies of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J three times. Drag the copy to the left until it snaps together with the middle shape. Make the layer below it active and drag it to the right until it snaps together. Make the next layer active and repeat. Make the second layer from the top active and invert it. Make the top layer active and invert it. Hide the background. Merge the shapes together by shift-clicking on the bottom shape to highlight all the layers and press Ctrl or Command E. Make three copies of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J three times. Drag the copy straight down until it snaps together with the other shapes. Then invert it. Make the second layer active and drag it up until it snaps together with the shapes below it. Then invert it. Make the next layer active and drag it up until it snaps together. Then hide the guidelines. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.